best piece of advice I got when I was young, when my father said to me, if you're going to be, you're going to do something, be good at it. In other words, do your best whatever you're going to do. No matter, and I think that applies to everyone in life, whether you're going to be a doctor or a footballer or an engineer, I think that's good advice. The best thing about Manchester United is its history. It's a fantastic history. It's not just, you know, the last few years. It's a long, rich history, going back to, you know, over 100 years. But obviously, after the war, there's an acceleration of excitement, you know, from Busby's day right to present day. There's something always happened at United. The manner in which they play, the number of great players they've had, the trophies they've won. You know, it's a fantastic history. Well, for some terrific bargains, you know, Peter Schmeichel only cost 500,000 way back in 1991. Brian McClair, Dennis Irwin, Steve Bruce, Eric Cantona. They're all really cheap buys, you know. You know, cost very little money, but turned out fantastic footballers. But then you'd have to, you can maybe say then that Roy Keane at £3 million was just as big a bargain, even though it was a lot more money than the players I mentioned. But the value he's given us, the service he's given us, it's, you know, it's always hard to equate exactly what people perceive as a real value. Well, I mean, I think that it's obvious that the last decade really has been Arsenal and Manchester United. So the rivalry between George Graham and myself and Arsene Wenger and myself has always been the forefront of the two clubs. Probably the Liverpool fixture and the Arsenal fixture, really, and probably the Derby game against City. But the Liverpool game is, to my mind, is the biggest Derby game we have. Well, Manchester United.